Hi, welcome back to JoJo Lab. Not too long ago, we revealed Google's unreleased 65 watts charger on Twitter, and we took it apart immediately. JoJo Lab found that it didn't adopt GaN components, but it can still be so small. So let's take it apart and find out the reason. Firstly, it's just the prototype. We're not sure if it will be released and when it will be released. It adopts pure white except for the button, which is black. It adopts foldable pins and the USB-C is on the top. The letter G is engraved here. Let's take a look at the specs. Model is G8JK8LPS. It supports input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 1.5 amp, and output of 5 volts, 3 amp, 9 volts, 3 amp, 12 volts, 3 amp, 15 volts, 3 amp, 20 volts, 3.25 amp. It also supports PBS of 3.3 to 21 volts, 3.25 amp, and the maximum power is 65 watts. Manufacturer is Agbell Technology. The charger is even a little bit smaller than Google 30 watts. Compared to Apple 65 watts charger, the size is just half of it. And compared to Apple 20 watts charger, just slightly longer than that. The length is about 51.59mm, the width is about 42.7mm, thickness is about 25.85mm. So the power density is 1.13 watts cubic centimeter. The weight is about 88 grams. Use JoJoLab Power ZKD002 to test the protocol. It supports QC, PD, and PPS fast charging protocols. And the PDO information is the same as what's printed on the button. Then let's take it apart. The internal module is connected to the plug through two wires. We cannot take out the internal module, so we have to use the Dremel to destroy the shell. Okay, finally, we made it. Here is the heatsink, and a layer of copper foil is attached to the heatsink. The black insulating plate is between the heatsink and the PCB components. After removing the heatsink, we can see the internal module is composed of multiple PCBs. The silicon adhesives and thermal pads are used for heat dissipation. Clean it up. A small PCB at the input is between two main PCBs, used for conduction and support. and the USB-C is soldered to another small PCB at the output. The third small PCB is next to it, and the protocol chip is on it. ShutterLab found it adopts high-performance active clamp flyback topology, and the protocol can control the output voltage. The entire module is very compact. Now we will introduce all components one by one. The SMD fuse is very small, 250 volts. There are two common mode chokes used to suppress EMI interference, and the yellow insulating plate can isolate it from PCB. Those three diodes are used to form the bridge rectifier circuit. Another same diode is on the other side. There are no components on the input small PCB, just to connect and support two main PCBs. The large capacitor on the primary circuit comes from Rubicon, 400 volts, 82 microfarad. The primary controller comes from Texas Instruments UCC28780. Working frequency can be up to 1 MHz. It can support GaNFET and integrates multiple protective functions. And the driver also comes from Texas Instruments, model is UCC27712. It has dual inputs with output interlock. Those two MOSFETs of the primary circuit adopt Infineon CoolMOS IPL60R185C7, 600 volts, 185 milliohm. Here is the transformer. The SMD Y capacitor between the primary and secondary circuits comes from Murata, and the Cosmo optocoupler is next to it, used to communicate and adjust the output voltage. The synchronous rectifier controller of the secondary circuit comes from MPS MP6908A, and its maximum switching frequency can reach 600 kHz. The synchronous rectifier MOSFET comes from ON Semiconductor. There are two Chemet's tantalum capacitors at the output, which are connected in parallel and used for output filtering. Here are two solid capacitors. The first one is 25 volts, 330 microfarad. The other one is 25 volts, 220 microfarad. The output VBUS MOSFET comes from Infineon BSZ035N03MSG, with standard voltage is 30 volts. The output filter inductor comes from Wealth. The protocol chip is in the middle of the small PCB, model is Wellchand WT6633P. It supports PD3, QC4, QC4+, QC5 and passed the USB IF certification. It also integrates 8051 core output current sensor, constant voltage and current controller, and complete protective function. This is the USB-C receptacle. Well, that's all components inside of Google 35W charger. The first impression is its compact size, and many people will regard it as a GaN charger, but is even smaller than Google 30W without GaN components. The AFC topology can bring high efficiency, and multiple PCBs can make full use of the space inside and further reduce the size. And that's the reason why it can be so small. Most components come from well-known international brands such as Infineon, Texas Instruments, ON Semiconductor, Wellchand, and Rubicon. However, since this is only a prototype, all the information above is for reference only. Okay, that's all for today's video. Hope you like it. You can click the corners to view the teardown videos of other powerful 65W chargers. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!